Canada is once again on the eve of conflict, preparing for a crisis unfolding halfway around the world. Thousands of soldiers are gearing up for deployment to Atropia, where humanitarian needs are high and becoming more desperate by the day.
There are reports hundreds of civilians have been killed or seriously hurt after heavy fighting between forces from Ariana and Atropia. The worst hit provinces include Ujjar, Kurdamir, and Haji Gabul. Residents in those communities report significant damage to hospitals, schools, and other public institutions. Aid agencies say the attack by Ariana has prompted an estimated 50,000 internally displaced persons to flee their homes. Atropia's relationship with two of its neighbors in the South Caucasus, Ariana and Limeria, has always been sensitive and prone to conflict. The dispute over the lower Janga region being one of the most painful in recent memory and the source of thousands of displaced persons in Atropia. But even as the government keeps a watchful eye over the tentative solution in place for that conflict, it's dealing now with another overwhelming crisis as more displaced people flood the country ahead of the Ariana invasion. Ownership of the oil and gas fields contained in the Caspian Sea has long been a point of contention. Ariana covets the rich resources that sustain Atropia's economy. The country has made no secret of the fact it wants full control of the hydrocarbons and the infrastructure required to move their products to market.
We've been monitoring the situation for a long time, and we've known that something more serious or more sinister was likely to happen. It's as if there have been sparks smoldering for years, and a full-out fire was just inevitable.
Robert Alain Contrasty is Canada's former ambassador to Atropia. He says the two countries have shared friendly bilateral relations since the early 1990s, with common interests in the commercial, cultural, government, and diplomatic sectors. Canada provides significant humanitarian assistance to the Caucasus region, often through NGOs. Polls show the majority of Canadians support the country's involvement. The former ambassador points out Canada's membership in NATO implies an obligation to help countries that are not necessarily part of NATO, but do belong to the Partnership for Peace program. He says that's just one of the reasons joining the multinational coalition makes sense.
The South Caucasus and the country of Atropia in particular is of key strategic importance to us and regional stability in the area, given the geographic link between Europe and Asia is a huge issue. And undoubtedly, transshipment of goods to the West will be affected. And of course, that will have an effect on Canada's own security interests.
For many months, the security situation in Atropia had been deteriorating as forces from Ariana adopted a more threatening posture. Their military is the second largest in the region behind Denovia's. Over that time, news agencies in the region reported a jump in cyber-related activities, disruptions of private and public sector systems, general social unrest, and an increased military presence along the shared border. In response, the Atropian government increased its internal and external security, mobilizing reserve forces and promising heightened awareness for the safety of its citizens. Against this backdrop of rising tensions, the government of Ariana announced it was taking military action to liberate Atropian citizens with ethnic ties to Ariana dating back centuries from persecution by the, quote, despotic Atropian dictatorship. A year ago, the United Nations Security Council issued the first coordinated attempt by the international community to deter Ariana from further action. UNSCR 7730 encouraged member states to, quote, strengthen Atropia's capabilities for self-defense through the provision of military assistance programs of all types. Canada responded by strengthening an already existing training mission in Atropia to better prepare the country's armed forces for the current conflict. The original mission was launched in 2006 and involved working with the Atropia military under the auspices of NATO's Partnership for Peace program. Within weeks of the UN resolution, a ship operated by the Atropian National Oil Company sank in the Caspian Sea after shots were fired, allegedly by an armed Navy vessel from Ariana. 12 crew members on the Etropian ship died. In the wake of that incident, the UN Security Council issued a second resolution, this time authorizing member states working in a coalition environment to form a multinational force should the actions of Ariana encroach on the Etropian sovereign territory. As part of that UN mandate, Canada is one of several countries who've agreed to be part of a US-led force that aims to bring an end to hostile actions by Ariana.
We consider maintaining the security of our country and the region as our historic responsibility.
Communities of Etropian Canadians, meanwhile, are calling on the world to pay more attention to what they say is a worsening humanitarian crisis in their homeland.
Teşekkürler Kanada'nın hükümetine ve bizim uşaklara, İskender'e.
An estimated 10,000 people of Etropian descent live in Canada, with the largest concentration found in Toronto. Anvar Tosanto Kamala is a visiting professor who teaches Etropian history at a number of Canadian universities. Dr. Kamala says Canada needs to do more.
We're hoping that the Canadian government can provide more direct military support to our country. We're also hoping that Canada and the other countries in the world will continue with the sanctions against the Ariana regime. And we hope that with the support of Canada and the global community, the Ariana regime will learn that its bullying tactics will not be tolerated.
Dr. Kamala says Etropia is becoming increasingly vigilant in ensuring Ariana doesn't exploit internal threats such as the high-profile Salasil or SAPA, South Etropian People's Army, its goal being to create a separate state carved out of southern Etropia and the northwestern provinces of Ariana, where the majority population would be ethnic Etropian. Diplomatic efforts to end this conflict are still underway, but at this point, hope is fading. The United Nations, under Resolution 7739, asks Canada and other coalition countries to prepare for an international intervention as part of a campaign to restore a level of peace and security to the region. In a brief statement, Canada's Prime Minister discussed the importance of ending the conflict. Canada and Etropia have been solid partners for many years now. Together with our allies, we stand side by side to safeguard the well-being of the Etropian people and the sovereignty of their country. To that end, we will support the military engagements and the enforcement of internationally agreed sanctions.
The Prime Minister said, referring to Etropia as an emerging secular democracy, where Canada has had a long-standing presence dating back to the early 1990s. This has been a special ANTV News report. I'm JC Kenney.